Well, you've reached the last video, or at least I believe it's the last video. Here's what you need to do in order to complete this quest and request approval. Okay? Hey, Scotchko. Hey, look, I did this. Well, that's not enough, because did you watch that last video? Because that's where Scotchko said, hey, look up some famous painters. You know, they've got to be 100 years old or more, so the work is no longer copyrighted. You can search through Wikimedia Commons. It's a great place to go. Just because someone went and took a picture of a Robert Rauschenberg work and put it up as CC0, that doesn't necessarily mean it's copyright free, because Rauschenberg worked. I was still alive when he was working. So figure it out. You're going to play nice. So I need at least 3 different artists. I need you to familiarize yourself with at least three different artists, and not do the same thing again and again and again. And you don't have to do this Illustrator thing. I wanted to show you how Illustrator could play a part. And to be honest with you, I wanted to do something different, because you saw my folder. I have, well, let's look. How many MasterPixels? I have 86 images in this MasterPixel file. That's insane. Okay? That's from 64 pixels, the same 64 that are in the starter file. So don't tell me you can't come up with ideas. I'm just going to come over here and say, hey, Mona Lisa. I'm going to click on this. I'd like to do the Mona Lisa. So I'm going to drag this down. You don't want a big image. See, size of this preview, 402 by 599. The other picture was about 600 pixels. You don't want to get much bigger than that. And you probably don't want to go with the little dinky one, but this is a great size to start with. Drop this on Photoshop. Because when you zoom in, whoa, look at the pixels. Look at the differentiation. And when you get up in the higher quality images, you'll actually see the cracks in the painting where the paint has cracked. And that, you don't want areas of all the same color pixel. And you don't want obvious patterns showing up. So you look for something that's really sweet. And I'm going to hold down the H key and click, and then move this over here and say, hey, what about up here? Ooh. And then what size am I going to pick? Now, I went with 8x8. You can do any size within reason. Hey, I did one that's 500 by 500. No, 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 no. You know, keep small. And you can do fixed size and say, I want to do, I'll give you a clue, odd numbers, that pixel in the center, screw you up every time, okay? Stay with even numbers. It works much better. There's my clue for you. So I'll just click 10 by 10. So there's 100 pixels, 10 by 10. So I click, and there's a 10 by 10 square. And you think, geez, that's pretty big. I don't know if I want that. Maybe Scotchko was right. Maybe I should go 8 by 8. I don't know. You figure it out. And then you click, and there's your 8 by 8. And then you look for just the right zone. And when you get it, hit Command J. Boom. And there it is. And you can put, you know, sky. It doesn't matter, because you can always find it. If I hit Command 0 to fit this in, Command 1 to make it the same, the right size. Here, all I have to do is hold down the Command key and click on this thumbnail here. Click. And there it is, right there. And so I can see it, and I can zoom in on it. Where'd it go? I'll hold down the H key and go over that right there. Now I got it. Okay, holding down H is great when you're zoomed in. You hold down H. Don't let it go. Hold down H. Hold down the mouse button. You can go wherever you want. Click and hold. I'm still holding down H. And you get that little preview of where you're going. So you got that selected? Command C. Command N. Guess what? It's 8x8 pixels. Make a new one. Command V. Command E. Merge down. Command 0. There's full size. There's your 8x8 pixels. Do something incredible. It's up to you. 3 different masterpieces. I want you to learn something and try different things. I want you to show me that you've been learning. Okay? And I want to see all the layers, so don't be faking anything. Use smart objects. Use camera raw. Don't just throw adjustment layers at it. All of these adjustment layers, well, except for, well, most of these adjustment layers are inside the camera raw filter. So, yeah, there are some that aren't in there. But trust me, It's a great way to work. It's a great way to get to know these programs and have some fun and get to know a few artists you're unaware of. Hey, how about Caravaggio? Hey.